Now this is no ordinary story. This story begins when I first met Kai. Kai is one of those guys that you try to be on his good side at all times. I seen him do some crazy shit. A while back, he told me how to plan to do something big, but at the time, I didn't know how big. He told me when it was time for the plan to be executed, he would give me a call, but until then, just wait patiently. So one day, I'm just chilling at home, and Kai calls me. He goes, "Yo, I have someone I need you to meet." So we talk for a little longer, and decide on a meeting spot for him to pick me up, so he can take me to the secret meeting spot. Once I was in the car, I was told not to mention where we were going to anyone. When Kai first told me I was meeting someone to do some crazy shit with, I wouldn't expect to meet one of the richest men in the city. He's basically the Iron Man of my heart. I guess we never really know someone.
You know why you're here yet, or nah?
I'm guessing it's to do with the drifting thing that you're thinking about.
Yeah, me and Kai and a few of the other big boys are looking to do like it's just apparently a drift crew in the city, but like an actual drift crew that actually hits licks and actually does shit. Doesn't just call themselves a crew and drive around shitty Hondas all day.
we're talking about
sharing money and investing money into each other to get everybody a one-of-one drift car and shit like that, making sure building it from the top and whatnot, like I did with this one.
Oh, so, I'm down.
When the cars are done, we can go hit our first lick. Which is Atomic is on my radar because we need tires.
Oh shit, yeah?
Yeah, we need a lot of tires.
That bitch is so fucking expensive, I can't hold you.
Yeah, I'm sick of burning through tires and just paying for it. So I think we should hit Atomic once we've got our cars all set. We're still thinking of a name. If you got any input, feel free to put it in there. And then we'll start brainstorming some cars.
Guy's not gonna like this, but Midnight Club.
Oh, slap you right now. I told you, didn't I, bro? I told you he would say that.
Yeah, he's cringe. But anyway, alrighty, I'm gonna head out. I'm gonna go do some more paperwork for the hospital shit, and then we'll talk later tonight.
So, a couple weeks have passed since I last met with Tyler and Kai, and after searching far and wide, we found everyone needed for the crew. We found people that specialize in many different things necessary to do this job. Let me introduce you to them.
Yeah, this is a nice angle. Ooh.
Oh.
definitely got something sick. We're trying to get in without anyone listening. Guys have a right glass as always.
What up, what up, what up?
Shit, it's his car.
Alright, everybody in their foreigns.
Everybody hear me? Alright, here's the plan. Because we haven't done anything illegal yet, we can cruise there much longer and take pictures on the way. Even if cops see us, it's not a big deal. As we get to Atomic, we just gotta make sure that nobody tails us, which they may because we look kinda out of place. But when we get there, it's literally just kick the door down, start putting tires in the back of the Raptor, make sure, like, try to get tires that fit specifically our cars. I mean, what is that, 245? Whatever, like, just try to get tires that seem like they'll fit. Please, no, like, mud off-road tires. I don't care if you have a Ram at home, just cars, tires for our drift cars.
Mm-hmm.
And we put all the tires in our in a hideout place somewhere. Where is that? Where should we do that?
You do it up north into the junkyard. I own a storage unit down there.
I actually have a really good idea of where we can store all of our shit in Sandy Shores.
Yeah, I have a junkyard in Sandy. I have a storage unit down there.
Okay, that's the final place then. After we hit the lick, we gotta make sure that on the way to Sandy Shores, no cops see us, because the second we leave, the alarm is going to go off, the cops are going to have descriptions of our vehicles because of the CCTV footage, and then on the way up to the highway, we got to make sure that no cops see us.
Listen, look, Atomic is right there. We take Innocence Boulevard up, then we take a left. Actually, no, just keep going up, and we pass that fucking old ass.
Just let Luz lead the way. Make sure the truck's always in the middle. It doesn't matter the pack. Just keep it consistent.
I know it's a
doable. If someone in front of you swerves and loses control, the whole train behind that person needs to stop and let them get back into place. No overtaking and mixing up. The truck needs to be in the middle.
Yeah, just I'll stay in front. Whoever wants to be behind me, we'll do that.
So I think we hit Atomic and then go down and around. So we go Atomic down. Everybody got their map open?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So you see where Atomic's at? It's like, what is it? Postal 9174 or something like that?
It's Atomic? No, it's 9061.
Oh yeah, 9061. So you go straight down to Little Bighorn. You see where Jamestown is, where it's Carson and Jamestown. You're gonna make a left there onto El Rancho and then get on the highway and go straight.
I think when we get on the highway, we should take the right exit, go around the right way on the Route 15.
Yeah, we could do that.
You could even take the right exit and then hit Sonora Way.
Yeah, that leads
directly into Sandy, and it's
yeah,
not
let,
the main
let's
highway.
Do that. Let's do that. So, everybody, we're going to take Route 15, Palomino Freeway, and then get off on Sonora Way, which is by the power station, and then we can cruise. We don't need to. Once we get off on Sonora, we don't need to give it the beans. There's literally no cops. There's zero chances of cops.
Devil, where's your storage locker exactly in Sandy?
Literally in the junkyard.
Yeah.
Like, okay. It's in the junkyard. Oh, that'd be easy. So you go to Sonora, across the highway.
Literally
and
straight. Yeah.
Right.
Mhm. Hey, understand the plan?
Mhm.
Yes. Yeah. Copy.
My truck parked up against the garage.
Alright, start grabbing shit.
Alright, let's get it.
Are we looking on the tires? Are we looking on tires?
Are we looking on tires?
We've got some in the back of the truck already.
Alright, I got some. Watch out, right quick.
Anybody
I hear a car. I hear a car.
They went past. They went past. They went past.
Okay. Alright, how y'all doing? I got a set for my car.
Currently repeating.
Spray paint our name.
Oh yeah, what do you think I'm doing?
Looks like everything's gone. Yep.
Alright, we got what we needed. Let's tag this shit and go, man.
Alright, I tagged it.
Yeah, tag it.
Everyone ready?
We all good to go?
Alright, let's go, let's go.
Cue the epic music.
Go. Hey, the water plant is probably going to catch us on CCTV too again, you know what I mean? Alright, send it. Sorry, the CCTV footage must have caught us, you know? Hey, where's Tony?
Dude, I got blocked by a localized hero.
We made it here safely.
I'm gonna fuck up my wheels, bro.
It's all about getting back to the city safely now.
I should just gotta pull in here because they're gonna be patrolling Sandy now that they know we're up in this area.
Now we're pulling in, but
fucking
wooden foot's
not fucking noise.
Which one? The train? Oh, I see it. Alright, let's go. Watch out.
Are we mid-air safely? Let's get it. Alright boys, I think the hard part is going to be getting back in the city safely.
Nah.
I know where to go. Don't worry.
We can just go left on Joshua and then go up. Like, I know where to go. It's easy. We're gonna have to go the long way, but it's easy to get the fuck out of here.
Alright, bro.
Oh!
Alright, let's get the fuck on out of here, fellas. Evo wanna take the lead. Are you gonna go left on 68 up to Jillian?
Do you need more help? Do you need help? Any more turns, or you got all of them?
Nah, I only got two for me. I'm not fucked to take everything.
Go. That was some crazy drifts on the way back, right? Formation on the way back, we're just gonna like end it.
Formation. Until we hit the city, because our garages are all in different places.
Alright, bye.
play clever if you wanna survive. Once you cross the line, you'll be wishing you would listen when you meet your demise.
Alright, now we kinda gotta drive it like we stole it, I won't lie.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Cop,
they're gonna be heated right now, so don't drive fast. They're gonna be looking to arrest them. But our tiger's still there.
Oh. Man, she only just noticed this place come. Shall we just keep on driving?
Can I
possibly
get you
inside
out of the vehicle
and
have a talk for you?
In the middle of the road.
Go to the street, I got binoculars on me. Oh, wait, there's another one.
Go on the bridge. I can spat tape on the bridge. Above us? Above us.
Yeah. What's going on over there?
Yo, you guys still on radio?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, like Tyler and Devil, I'm watching them right now. Actually, T, if
you're
on radio,
look above me, look behind you, yes.
Yeah, look at the bridge.
Wait, y'all are on the bridge?
Yeah, I'm looking at them with binoculars right now. They got pulled
over. You can see them from the bridge? Right, I'm
pulled. Why'd you guys get pulled over?
Yeah, what was that about? I don't know, they were just stopping every vehicle that was driving by for a description. Of what they saw. And Lucifer said that he saw sports cars gave like very broad, like, one was orange, one had a livery.
Yeah, I basically just told them the broadest terms ever they shit themselves.
We did it. We successfully pulled off the heist and got everything safely to the storage unit. Now that we acquired more tires, doing more heists are going to be way easier. This heist was just a stepping stone to a bigger picture. It looks like the cops were also clueless to who did it, and also too late. Maybe next time, or not.